To improve power factor, we need to add equal and opposite amount of reactive power to the circuit. This we have seen in detail in our previous videos of power factor series. Now, in this video, we will have a look at three most commonly used ways for improving power factor. So, to get the details, you need to watch the video. Before moving on in this video, I will strongly recommend you to watch previous videos of power factor series. You'll get link for those videos down in the description. So, after understanding how you can improve power factor, it is very clear that you need to add equal and opposite amount of reactive power to the circuit to improve power factor. So, the ways to improve power factor are nothing but the ways to generate reactive power. Following are the three most commonly used ways. Number one, capacitors or capacitor banks. Number two, synchronous condenser. And number three, phase advancer. Reactive power generated by these three ways is capacitive in nature, as most of the time the load is inductive load like transformer, induction motor, and etc. Capacitors or capacitor banks are most commonly used methods for power factor correction. You will find them almost everywhere. As we all know, most of the time load is inductive, which take lagging current and decreases the power factor. So, for power factor improvement purpose, capacitors are installed in parallel with such loads. Capacitor provides leading current which neutralizes the lagging component of inductive load. Thus, the power factor of system improves. We have seen the detail of how this happens in our previous video. This method of improving power factor is the cheapest one. Also, the capacitor requires very low maintenance and it has very low losses. But switching of capacitor banks causes switching surges on the system. Now, APFC panels, that is automatic power factor control panel, are also used, which automatically makes the switching of capacitor based on the requirement. When a synchronous motor operates at no load and overexcited, then it is called as synchronous condenser. Whenever a synchronous motor is overexcited, then it provides leading current and works like a capacitor. Let's see how a synchronous motor supplies reactive power. The MMF needed to produce the constant flux phi may be produced by either the stator, which is connected to a three-phase line, or by the rotor, which is excited by a DC source, or by both. Now, if the rotor excitation current is zero, all the amp flux has to be produced by stator only, and hence stator must absorb the reactive power from three-phase line. But if we excite the rotor with DC current, rotor's MMF will help to produce the part of required flux, and less reactive power will be drawn. If we raise the excitation of rotor, it will produce all the required flux by itself, and no reactive power will be drawn from three-phase line. Now, we can say the power factor of motor is unity. If we overexcite the rotor, what will happen? Stator, instead of absorbing reactive power, will actually start delivering it. The motor then behaves like a source of reactive power, just as it were a capacitor. Of course, the level of excitation depends on how much reactive power you want. Synchronous condenser can also be linked with PLC-based controller with power factor controller and a regulator, which will automatically control the excitation and generate the required reactive power. Synchronous condensers are generally used by large power users as it is very costly. Phase advancer are mainly used to improve power factor of induction motors. Phase advancer is a simple AC exciter which is connected to the main shaft of the motor and operates with the motor's rotor circuit for power factor improvement. Frankly speaking, I don't have much information about power phase advancer, but the principle is same. As induction motor is inductive in nature, it takes lagging current from the system, and phase advancer provides leading current, which eliminates the reactive component, which will further improve power factor of the motor. Well, if you have any idea about the phase advancer, you can let me know down in the comments. So let's summarize this video. Power factor improvements method are nothing but the means of generating reactive power. Most commonly used methods are capacitor bank, synchronous condenser, and phase advancer. Capacitor banks are most commonly used as they are very cheap and require less maintenance. Synchronous condenser is generally preferred by large power customers as the cost is very high. Phase advancer is used for power factor improvement of induction motor. If you found the video helpful, do share it with your friends. Do subscribe to my YouTube channel for future updates. You can also visit my website www.theelectricalguy.in for more videos and articles about electrical engineering. That's all for this video. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, keep watching, keep learning.